I'm Chef Shel Hoop, and welcome to my kitchen. Today, we're going to do something special for Halloween. We're going to make witch's fingers. So first of all, let me take you through the recipe. I have 2 sticks of butter softened. Who does that remind you of? I love butter. Okay, 2 sticks of butter, and get those in. And then I'm going to turn on my sheen, and I want to get those whipped up. So I want it nice and creamy and smooth. Then to that butter, okay. To that butter, I am going to add 3/4 of a cup of sugar. So 3/4 of a cup, if you don't have a 3/4 cup measurement on your set, it's a half a cup plus 1/4. I'm just gonna just slowly pour it in. That's my half. And this is my fourth. This is called creaming. Creaming the butter and the sugar together. This is very, very important to get the right consistency for your cookies. And you want to get the sugar incorporated into the butter, and you want to whip air into it. It makes it a little more fluffy. So once that gets done, then we're going to add another ingredient. I'm just going to put a pinch of salt in because we don't need too much. My other ingredient will be an egg. All right, so the longer you can let that go, the better. Now for the egg. Never crack the egg onto the machine. What if you get a shell in there? What if you have a blood spot on the egg? Wouldn't that be horrible? Okay, looking good. In goes the egg. Let that blend up. Don't put anything else in until you're ready. We want to put some flavoring in here. Now, I don't have vanilla extract today, so I'm using orange blossom water. And just about a teaspoon or so will do it. And then we want to put in our flour. Now, I'm going to turn this down because I don't want flour flying into my face. And I'm going to just slowly add it. That was cup number 1. I'm going to do cup number 2. Well, let's just get that incorporated a little bit more. Now, you want this dough to be kind of the consistency of play dough. If it's too soft, it's not going to look right because we're making fingers, and witch's fingers are typically and that's why we're not putting any kind of baking soda or baking powder in here. The egg actually is going to make it kind of expand a little bit. Okay, let me just get this going a little faster. Okay, add a little more flour. Okay, I am at the 3-cup mark. All right, now I want to just check it to make sure it's the right consistency. It's a little too sticky. Okay, so I think I'm going to add a little bit more, but I'm only going to add 1/4 cup at the moment. And we'll see how that works. Okay. So here's how it's going to go. So here's how it's going to go. You have your baking pan with your parchment paper on there. And you're going to pull out a little piece of dough, not much. And you're going to roll it into a little cigar shape. You know, they say that everything you need to learn, you learn in kindergarten. You learned how to do this in kindergarten. You just squeeze it in your fist and it makes this really cool shape. Doesn't it look like a witch's finger? Okay, so just go along like that. And if they're a little crooked, all the better. We now want to put the fingernails on. So I'm using slivered almonds, but any kind of nut works, even a whole almond. Walnuts will make them look even yuckier. Is that a word, yucky? Okay, so here we go with the fingernails. Alrighty. And then you see how your hands have these little wrinkles? So you want to do that also, because we have to make them look kind of authentic. Also, if you want, you can put some warts on here. That always looks good. It's better if they're a different color, but I'm just gonna show you what you can do just to make it look even weirder. A few little warts here and there never hurt anybody. Alright, now in order to make our fingers look extra special, you want to put an egg wash on them. It's very important because it gives it a nice, warm, glowy color and that nice, shiny look. So you just kind of like blend up the egg really well. And then you get your little baster and you just baste them with egg. And it also kind of helps the fingernail to say, oh, we lost a wart. Okay. I'll just stick that little guy back on there. Okay. We're good. We're good? Yes? Okay, so then all you have to do is put them in the oven, 350 degrees Fahrenheit, for about 20 to 25 minutes. So you want them kind of like a golden brown. All right, now I have some already made. I want to show you how to put the blood on there. Here are some fingers that I already made. And of course, as you see, these warts are green and yellow. But it's missing the blood because these are fingers that are cut off from the hand. You have to have the blood. So I'm going to show you how to make royal icing. That's the icing that gets hard when it dries. So I have here 2 cups of powdered sugar, and you have to sift it, because if you don't sift it, it gets lumps. All right, so I'm just going to put it through my sifter quickly. Okay, that looks good. And then the secret ingredient would be our egg white meringue. Our meringue powder, dried egg whites, okay? So I'm gonna put in 1.5 tablespoons of egg white. Just blend that all up. Try to get as even as possible. That's all you need. And then I have here some warm water. And let's see, 3 tablespoons of warm water. And hopefully that will do it. Okay, this looks just a little bit too thick. I want it a little bit runny. So I'm just gonna put just maybe a couple of drops of water, not too much. And this took about a good minute of really hard stirring. Nope, still not loose enough. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and put another tablespoon. Because you want it to flow a little bit. Okay, that's much, much better. And then we want to put our red food coloring, and I do recommend getting the paste. It just seems to work a little bit better. Okay. Brand new paste. All right. And we get that paste in there. Oh boy. Ooh, that looks good already. Okay, so that little container of red food coloring wasn't a dark enough red, so I'm adding some regular liquid red food coloring to my mix to help make it a darker red. All right, and actually the liquid from the red food coloring helps to make it a nice consistency. So all we're gonna do is take our cookie and we're just gonna drizzle the blood on. And what's nice about this is that once it dries or hardens, you won't get your hands all dirty from the icing. Okay. Look at that. Ooh. Pretty cool, huh? Now, if you have a missing fingernail, all you have to do is just stick it on with some of this blood icing. Makes it pretty authentic. And if you don't want to dip it, you can just drizzle the blood on. Ooh, yeah. Look at that. Okay. When these get all nice and hard, then you could just pick them up and the icing won't bother anything. Of course, right now it's still a little bit wet. But doesn't that look kind of disgusting? Yeah, that's just exactly what we wanted. Disgusting. Yum. Mmm.